Hi, welcome to Dr. Brainwaves. This is Dr. Susan Raschal, and I am Dr. Rena Azar. Today, Dr. Raschal is going to talk to us about another type of urticaria or hives, which is a condition that affects a large number of the population, 20%. Today, she's going to talk about delayed pressure urticaria.
This type of urticaria is not really an urticaria at all. And the reason why I say that, although it's classified as urticaria, but you usually don't have those red, raised, itchy bumps with this particular condition. And what happens is if you are applying pressure to something for an extended period of time, then what can happen is where you're applying that pressure, you can have swelling. So what's interesting about it is that you don't have the swelling right away. Usually 3 to 8 hours later is when you develop the swelling. So that's the reason why it's considered delayed pressure urticaria. And let me give you an idea of if someone comes in and we suspect a person may have this delayed pressure urticaria, what we do is what's called the sandbag test. And we will take a heavy object and we will strap it over, we'll actually have it hanging over their shoulder, and we'll let them hold on to that or let that rest or hang from their shoulder for at least 15 minutes. And then after that period of time, we remove it. Would you expect to see a reaction at that time? Nope. Why is that? Because it's a delayed pressure urticaria. So 3 to 8 hours later is when you may see this area swelling significantly, and it has nothing to do with what you applied right then. It has everything to do with what they came in contact with several hours before. Now, a common career that usually will cause, not usually, but can cause this condition is a mechanic. So if a mechanic is working underneath the car and they're putting a lot of pressure on that arm and they don't even realize it then, and then they go home at night and realize, oh my gosh, my arm is swelling over here, or their arm is swelling back here. And it's because of all the pressure they had applied underneath the car. Or if there's another career where a person has to hold something down for an extended period of time, then that may also be one of those risk factors, if you will, that can cause this delayed pressure urticaria. The other thing that's difficult about this condition is that usually it does not respond well to antihistamines, but it does respond well to oral steroids. And of course, that can be a double-edged sword, although oral steroids are extremely effective at decreasing swelling. Used over time, especially long periods of time, it can cause all kinds of severe side effects, diabetes, cataracts, osteoporosis. So it's not a medicine that we like to keep somebody on for a long period of time. So that is one of those conditions that really requires additional research. And there probably won't be a lot of research done in that particular topic because it affects such a small percentage of people and there's no benefit from a company to research it in the first place. So it is a frustrating condition for people, especially if their career causes them to have these recurrent episodes of swelling and it only responds to steroids. So stay tuned. There are other types of urticaria that aren't so frustrating and things that we can do about them.